Hi everyone, Etienne is here with a new episode to help you build better daily structure and be in control of your life. If you have ever wondered how you could unlock more of your brain's potential to be more focused, productive, and consistent, then I have some good news for you. There are simple but effective strategies that you can use to rewire your brain and unlock more of its potential. Today, we'll take a look at the book called Activate Your Brain to learn how understanding your brain can improve your work and life. If this is your first time on this channel, then make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon to get updates on my latest videos about time management and productivity. It's in our human nature to strive for improvements, become smarter, make better decisions, and solve problems more effectively. And one way we can achieve these benefits is by improving our brain's ability to perform at its best. Our brain and mind is our most valuable asset, and we can improve it by using different strategies and techniques. So let's take a look at some of the best takeaways from this book to learn how we can activate our brain. Number one, shift your focus. Do you go to work because you enjoy it or because you need to pay your bills? If the answer is latter, then you'll be always struggling with your work. Every working day will feel like torture. You'll be struggling to wake up in the mornings and you'll hate Mondays. The fact that you don't like your work will affect other areas in your life as well. Negative attitude towards one thing will create a chain reaction like falling dominoes. What you have to do is you have to change your mindset and start to see your work as something that you value, and that will change everything. Are you learning something new at your work? Amazing. Then focus on that. Are you saving money for your business? Great. Focus on that as well. The same goes for failure. You will be less afraid to try and fail if you know that you will be learning from it. Number two, put yourself in control. To put yourself in control, all you have to do is you have to follow this simple rule. Focus on the things that you can control and accept things that you can't. In your life, there will be always things that you can control, things that you can influence, and things that you can't control. You can control what actions you are taking and how you respond to the feedback that people are giving you. You can influence whether you'll get a promotion or not by working hard, educating yourself, and learning new skills. You can't control the weather conditions, traffic, or what people say or think, so the best thing to do is to accept it. If you try to control the things in your life that you can't control, then you will end up upset and angry, and that will in no way help you to feel better and perform at your best. Another way to be in control is to be ready. When you're ready for running competitions, then you are in control. When you have invested time, effort, and resources in market research, then you'll be in a position where you know what you're doing. Number three, get an accountability. Our brain works consciously and subconsciously, but most of the thinking happens in our subconscious mind, so it is important to utilize it. When we set goals for ourselves, we plan them deep into our minds, and even if we don't think about them, our mind is still trying to figure out how to achieve them. This is why it's important to have an accountability partner, or even better, an accountability coach who can help you to stay on track. When you say to yourself that you will exercise 3 times a week, but then you don't do it, it's easy to walk away from it. But when you make a statement to your coach that you will do it, then you'll have more motivation and drive to find time for these activities. Number four, build positive relationships. There is something magical about how humans bond to each other. We like to communicate and sometimes impress each other. Having a positive relationship with people gives us a great sense of belonging and satisfaction. Another great benefit of being social creatures is that it can help us to see situations from different perspectives. But you have to make sure that you build relationships with the right people. Look for people who have similar goals like yours. Number five, work together with others. We just spoke about the importance of building relationships. It is also the fact that we are performing better together. Teams of people outperform individuals, so when you have opportunity to collaborate, then you should always use it. This doesn't mean that you have to agree on everything. It's beneficial to look at the situations from different perspectives. There are multiple options for how you can work together. If you have a business, then you can build a team around you. If you are a single influencer, then you can do the joint ventures or collaborations. Number six, exercise your brain. To maximize the benefits of your brain, you should consider exercising it, and more often you do it, better it will function. There are generally two ways how you can nurture positive brain development and growth. One is giving it a mental exercise, and second one is physical exercise. Let's start with a mental exercise, as it is more directly related to the brain. This is anything that requires thinking and problem-solving skills. There are also many brain games available on the App Store that you can download and practice when you have a spare minute. Then there is physical exercise, and while it might seem that there is more benefits to your body, it also nurtures your brain. So make sure that you schedule time for exercise, about 3 to 5 times per week, as that will keep your body fit and mind healthy. Number 7, avoid stress and sleep debt. There are two things that you should avoid at all costs, because they'll have a negative impact on your brain function. First one is stress. While little stress can help you to take action, too much stress will create worries and fear. The best way to avoid stress is to start planning your time. Have a weekly schedule in place so that you know what are your commitments. The second thing is sleep debt. Many people try to sacrifice their sleep for a few extra tasks that they want to complete. But this strategy always backfires, and whatever you gained previous night, you'll be losing double in the next day. So be sure that you get enough sleep and you don't accumulate sleep debt, as that will slow down your brain and destroy your productivity. I hope that you enjoyed this Activate Your Brain book summary, and these strategies will enable you to unlock more of your brain's potential. If you enjoyed this video, I would really appreciate if you could press the like button, as this will help the video reach more people and spread the message.